today's episode, I want to explore kind of a topic of why don't you see more women in the vinyl community or maybe even your own record shops? Have you ever wondered where are they at? I don't know if you have. I have. Why am I the only girl? Where's everybody at? Sharing on YouTube, I soon found out I was not the only woman collecting records and into records. In fact, there's a few great YouTube channels out there. Vinyl Guru, who hasn't posted in a while, she's one of my favorite. We soon became great friends in 2021. So there's lots of women I know who are out there who are interested, but you just don't see it as much as you see the guys, the men. I wrote down a list of reasons what kept me from not pursuing records more than occasionally picking up here and there. And I thought, well, these reasons aren't just for women. I'm pretty sure these are some reasons why most people don't get into record collecting. So I want to share that with you. And also I had asked you guys, where are the girls at? And I got some cool responses. So I'm going to share that with you in today's episode. So some of the reasons that prevented me from pursuing records more was my stereo setup. I was pretty happy with the little basic record player I had that Gus had bought me. I wasn't really into advancing any more than that. And when me and Gus got married, we began to have room to accumulate records, and he began to slowly teach me how to build a stereo, and that was really fun. I can also be technical, and so I had a lot of fun piecing it together. It's a Frankenstein of a stereo. All pieces except for the record turntable is from Goodwill, and it took me about 6 months to find the turntable, project turntable, that I did end up going with. So I had to do research, and that was fun. That was really fun. Another reason why is there's so many other great things that girls buy. They have all sorts of different interests, and some of them would even say they lack hobbies, but I think those interests are hobbies. Fashion is a hobby. Sewing, I love sewing too. What are some other things they're into? Makeup, I guess that's a hobby, but that's more of a waste to me. But no, they get really into it and they buy all these makeups, hundreds of dollars of makeup. And they also learn how to do makeup on their friends and stuff. I had a few friends that were into that. And yeah, there's other things, furniture. And for me, I had to stop all that because I had quit my job to be a full-time mom. I no longer had that luxury of money just flowing so I just stopped buying clothes. I'm like, I'm happy with what I got. And I stopped buying expensive makeup. Drugstore is just as fine. And I had to stop buying things. And I figured one thing I could keep is I could buy one CD at the Goodwill for a few dollars. And yeah, I'm gonna save lots of money. I'll just get into my music. The funny thing is, it didn't save me a lot of money like I thought. I ended up spending a lot of money in records and CDs and stuff. And I really didn't think this was a whole thing. I didn't think this was a lifestyle, but really you just cultivate your life around music. It becomes the soundtrack of your life. Another reason that stopped me from really like growing in my record collection and my passion for music was that I was really shy about it. I didn't think anyone else was into this. My little world where I used to work, no one was into music. In fact, I kept it a secret. I kept it a secret I was into music. And it wasn't until I started sharing on YouTube, I'm like, people care, people watch, people are sharing what they love. It's a very unique part of our personality, I think, is the fact that we do love to share with each other the music. Another reason maybe I didn't really get into record collecting and maybe it might prevent other women, we're really busy. I mean, I have three little kids. Taking them to a record store is pretty crazy. I wish I could go early on a Saturday morning and stand in line with you guys to go get the newest releases. Like, that is fun. So when you do see those doors open and all the men rush in, the women are home, we're with the kids. If they're my age, they're with their friends, and it's very, we are very social. Women, we love to hang out. We love to, you know, go out to lunch and have fancy coffees. And so I never really went to the record store by myself before this at all. I would always call a friend. Even now, like, I'll still call a friend, my friend Christina, my cousin Isaiah, Gus, if he's here in town, my husband, he works a lot. Women aren't into record collecting, and maybe even men. is because they just don't grow up around it. No one around them is doing it. They don't know, like, what is it? It could be a bit of an artifact. I even seen a video of 8-year-old girls trying to open up a CD because they didn't even know what it was. They were so confused. And so when you don't grow up around a music lover like we are, it's very foreign. And so even in my world, I think I had only known like one record collector, and I did begin to ask him questions about like, what is an amp? What is a receiver? And all these questions that I had. And he's such a good teacher. He began to show me, and he even showed me his record collection and showed me his setup and how he put it together. So I began to learn from him. And then as I begin to share about the passion a little bit more with other people, they begin collecting. So my mom collects now, my dad collects, my aunt collects. And so that's really cool, the fact that I've become this like ambassador for records and CDs. I'm gladly take that position. And wherever you're at, you are gonna become that person to other people in your world. I asked you guys, why do you think like there's not a lot of women in the vinyl community, or maybe like, why don't we see or hear of them? And Adam said in his life, most women he knows that have physical media are passive about it. They might pick up a vinyl here and there. Kings K shared that he only knows a few other people who are into record collecting, not a lot of people. I think this is a problem. I don't get it. People are passive about listening to music, male or female. They're like, go buy a CD, go buy an album. I don't feel like a real fan of a band until I buy their album, and then it becomes personal and mine. Like, I didn't feel like a 21 Pilot fan when I was just listening to the music off of YouTube. It wasn't until I bought their CD where I'm like, now I'm rooting for them. Charles said, I wonder if the associated equipment has something to do with it. The typical audiophile, for example, is male and has more interest in the gear than the typical female. Steve shared that it was the women who brought him into sharing on YouTube. Oddly enough, it was watching two women's videos about record collecting that got him into making videos. Hannah the Ottoman Introvert and Melinda Murphy. Vinyl Record Mission Steve said he's gonna just ask his wife. He's not even gonna try to guess. And he said his wife just likes buying other things and like has other things to worry about, retirement. And yeah, I think that was one of the things. I was always kind of distracted by other things, but then I had to save my money. And so I'm like, I'm just gonna choose one. And music was like my special one. So I went with music. Oh, Chance from Concert Buddies, he shared that he thinks it's part of finding the right people to learn from and being able to ask questions freely outside of YouTube. Most of the time it feels like it's a family member or a partner and they can't seem to find that person to ask those questions. The interest flame goes out quicker for ladies. You know, some people may not have a person in their life that can show them about the gear. That's so true. And I think a good YouTube channel is Paul's YouTube channel because he is that engineering mind, and oh, it's so fascinating the way he like breaks it down. Sometimes he just shares about his taste in music, but other times he shares more about the science of music. So good. And so yeah, the YouTube channels over here, we are a great resources. I think I love watching VC videos because I'm like, who am I missing? Who's out there who has a great album and like I just haven't heard it, and I'm always looking for that gem. David R just said, hey, just go to a record store and just start looking. And I think that's a great place to start if you're interested in record collecting or CD collecting, male or female. Like, go to the record store and just start browsing. I remember feeling very lost and like I didn't belong here, you know, that Radiohead song played in my head, like I don't belong here. But after I stopped being self-conscious and like no one cares about me, everyone's like looking in their own record genre, I just started walking and browsing, and it was just really fun to look at the covers. And maybe that's where you're gonna start. And I think that's kind of where I did start. I started just looking at the covers and started being interested in the music by looking at it physically in front of me. One thing I have noticed is that the men do know how to sit back, relax, and recharge. And that is something I had to learn. As a mom of three, I'm super busy. There's so much to do and the work is never done. I needed something that was accessible in my house, something that I can go to and just pick up where I left off. I loved music ever since I was a teenager, so this was something I decided to just dive right into, the love of music. Searching for music and looking for music, that's something I really loved when I was a teenager. And now, as an adult, I can do it and also share music with the world and my family. And so this has just been so much fun, not only just to go to record shops, but also to look up music online, but then also to discover music. Like, that is so fun. I discover the artist, I discover the story. Now, this is a hobby. I don't have to go out. I don't even have to spend money. I have it. It's in my library already. I can enjoy it any time of the day, and that's something that I really love about record collecting. And now this is just a great avenue for me to express myself, and I'm so glad I got into this lifestyle. So there's some encouragement. If you're a girl out there, you want to get into record collecting and you think it's just a guy thing, no, it's an everybody thing. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Leave a comment down below of like, why don't you see women in vinyl collecting? All right, guys, I'll see you guys in the next episode.